gonna do some yoga. Step the feet apart. Heard this before. Come all the way forward. Keep the legs wide. Legs straight. Hands to the floor, or you can grab and pull down. Take some deep breaths. Keep the nose working open with the breath, not through the mouth, always through the nose.
On the oceans and on my houses, fish full of mercury.
From here, interlock the hands behind your back and drop them over your head. You can push the palms together if you want or not. If you have to bend the knees to make it easier on your low back, you can.
Mercy, 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 all things and what they used to be.
And bring the hands down to the floor. Roll slowly all the way up. We're going to do triangle pose, Chikonasana in Sanskrit. Turn the left foot out. Keep the feet wide apart. Bring the arms up. Inhale as you exhale. Extend out, bring the hand down. Shin or ankle or foot or floor. Look up towards the right hand. Try to roll the right ribs back. If it hurts your neck to look up, then look down. Take some deep breaths through the nose. Don't take it so seriously. Yoga is a celebration, sometimes. And nice and slow, come all the way up. Other side, same thing. Turn the right foot out. Come on out. Keep breathing. Turn the feet straight, or even better, a little pigeon-toed, and come forward again. That's enough of that. Roll all the way up. Step the feet together. Time to party. Bring the hands together. Inhale, the arms up, drop the head back. Exhale, come all the way forward. Hands flat down if possible. Lift the head up, inhale, jump back or step back. Top of a push-up position. Come down, slowly. Inhale and arch up into the upward facing dog. Just stay here for a few deep breaths. Really push the chest forward. Shoulders are down and back. You can drop the head back if you want to. Why aren't you dancing? Push back into the down dog. Walk the feet in toward the hands a little bit. Sink the heels down toward the floor. Arms are straight. Fingers are spread wide apart with the hands flat down. Make sure the neck is soft and relaxed. The more you can flatten the back, the better. Ideally, you'd be feeling this in the back of your legs. Also, you may not be conscious of it, but it's working your heart just to be in this position, which is nice. From here, lightly as you can, jump both feet up to the hands. Come into a chair pose. Bring the arms up in the air. Bend the legs, sink down. Lighten up, you guys are very stiff today. What's going on? You're hurting me. Okay, bring the hands down, straighten the legs. From here, roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back a little bit. Exhale, come all the way forward. What do you believe? Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. Come down. Inhale and arch up. Exhale and push back. You're just leaving me out to dry. That's okay, two can play that game. So, bring the right arm straight up in the air, turn completely to the side, one arm incline. Legs are straight, hips are up. If it's too hard on your wrist or elbow or shoulder or just on your pride, then you can bring the left knee down to the floor. If you have to, otherwise stay here. Look up. Try to smile even though it hurts. If it hurts, which it doesn't. And come down. Do the other side. If you want to add a push-up in between, that shows how crazy you are, but go ahead, do the other side. Okay, bring the hand down, come on down all the way. Inhale, arch up. Exhale, push back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Swing the foot immediately up to the hands, come into a crescent pose, straighten the back leg, stay on the ball of the back foot. As much as you can, keep the back leg straight. If that's too intense for you, bend the back knee, but try to bend the front leg into a right angle. Sink down a little bit more. What happened? You lost your sense of humor again. Bring the hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. Sink down slow. Inhale, arch up. Exhale, push back, down dog. Left leg up in the air. Just throw it up there, push the right heel down. Excelente, swing it up. Right into the crescent pose, other side. Down to the floor. Step the foot back. Sink down slowly. Arch up. We'll be right back. Yes. We're back. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. Arch back. More warm up for you. Exhale. Come all the way forward. This may be burnout rather than warm up. Lift the head. Jump back. Come down slow. That's the only thing slow. Inhale and arch up. Push back, exhaling. Okay, raise the right arm up in the air. Turn to the side, the one-armed incline. You're beginning to hate this, I'm sure.
I like it.
We're gonna hold it till I feel it. I haven't felt it in many years. All right, come down, do a push-up. Do the other side. Yeah. Fantastic. Bring the hand down. Come all the way down. Arch up. Upward dog. And push back. Down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Now, this may work, it may not, but we'll just try it and see what happens. Keep the right leg up in the air. See if you can raise the left hand off the floor, in front of you or out to the side or behind your back. If you fall, that's not unusual. Just try it again. It takes a little strength and a lot of balance. And bring it all down before somebody gets hurt. Let's try the other side. Left leg up in the air. Right hand off the floor this time. Whatever works best for you, in front, behind you. Different people like it different ways. But everybody likes it to this music. All right, bring it all down. Before your shoulders explode, you better jump the feet up to the hands. Roll all the way up. Stretch up. Exhale, come forward. Hands are down, head is up. Jump back or step back. Come down. Arch up, up dog. And push back, down dog. Raise the right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up into a crescent pose. From here, turn the back foot flat down. Turn to the side, warrior. Sink down into it with the right leg.
Chapter 7, verses 16 yeah. and 17. Yes, sir. They shall hunger no more.
Crank it.
Neither shall they thirst anymore. Preach, preach up. For God shall wipe away, yes, sir, every tear from their eyes. Yes, sir. Get ready for the revolution.
All right, slide the left hand down the back leg. Reach back with the right arm. The more you roll the right ribs and shoulder open, the better the stretch. Really extend with the right fingertips. See if you can turn the palm down toward the floor. At the same time, bend the right leg a little bit if you possibly can. And bring the right hand down to the floor, flat down to the inside or outside of the front foot. Whichever works better for you. Left arm straight up in the air, or if you can, straight over your head is also good. But keep rolling the left ribs open. Keeping the right leg bent, come back up into a warrior pose. That'll teach you to volunteer. Now from here, bring the right hand down. Reach underneath the front leg. Grab the left hand or wrist behind your back if you can. If you can't, don't worry about it. You can bring the right hand to the floor and just reach behind you with the left hand.
Very serious tonight.
Okay, bring the hands down. Step the foot back. Come down. Shake it out. Come down. Arch up. And push back. Down dog. Left leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose first. Turn the back foot flat down, turn to the side, warrior. Slide the right hand down the back leg. Reach back. Again, roll the shoulder open. Look up if you can. Most of the weight obviously is on the back foot, but you want to keep bending the front leg just to make it a little more intense if possible. And bring the left hand down to the floor. Flat down if you can. Right arm straight up in the air or straight over your head. Come back up, warrior. Keep smiling no matter what your thigh feels like. Take the left hand and reach underneath the left leg. Grab the right hand behind you. Again, roll the chest open as much as you can. And bring the hands down, step the foot back, sink down, arch up, push back, down dog, jump both feet up to the hands and just hang down with the legs straight, roll the weight toward the balls of the feet. We'll be right back.
You're watching Oxygen Media.
We're back. So roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back a little. If you want to arch back a lot, squeeze the butt tight as you go back. Protect your low back and then exhale and come all the way forward. Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. Come on down, unless you already have. And then arch up, up dog. Push back, down dog. You won't be coming down for a few hours after this. Right leg up in the air, push the left heel down. You can roll the hip open as usual. You can extend the heel or the toe, whatever you like better. And swing the foot up, crescent pose. Twist, hook the left elbow over the front leg into the prayer style twist, or bring the left hand to the floor, right arm up in the air. If the balance is a real problem or you're really stiff, you can bring the left hand to the inside of the foot. If you're all right, you can hook it over the right leg. In any case, really extend up with the right fingertips, rolling everything open, breathe, straighten everything.
Doctor, with that nurse.
Doctor?
Nurse.
Okay, bring the hands down to the floor. Step the foot back. And come down. Arch up, upward dog. Push back, down dog. Left leg up in the air.
You nasty boy.
Swing it up. Other side, crescent pose. Straighten the right leg. If you can't loosen up to this music, you need hospitalization. Or something. Do something. Slowly hook the right elbow or bring the right hand down. Into the twist, same thing, straighten the back leg, the right leg in this case. Now we got Reverend Al, we're happening. All right, hands down, step the foot back. Calm down.
3 o'clock in the morning.
Arch up. And push back. Down, down.
She can make it right, yeah.
Lightly jump the feet up to the hands. Sit down. Once you're down, turn this way. So your feet are facing that way. You're gonna bring the feet up in the air. Hands up like so. Into the boat pose. Now, if this is too intense for you, you can always bend the knees. This gets good after about 10 minutes. Someday I'll make good on that threat, but not today. Cross the arms over the chest. Sink the heels down a couple inches off the floor. Lean back a little, not too much. And then start grooving to the music. Slowly come up. Turn to face the front. Cross the legs if you can. Bring the hands flat down in front of the bent knees. Lean forward, jump the feet back. Now if that's too much, just crawl back, that's fine. Inhale, arch up. Exhale, push back, down and up. That was good. Right leg up in the air. Swing the foot up. Crescent pose.
Make you do right. Love will make you do wrong. Make you come home early.
From here, just lean the upper body out over the front leg. Keep the back foot down and just hang out here for a second. Now slowly straighten the leg. Come on up into the balance pose. Again, you can bring the arms behind you if you like that better. Bring the hands to the floor, leg up in the air, standing splits. Then bring the foot down, feet are together, hands are down. Roll all the way up, stretch up, really stretch. You can arch back if you want. Exhale, come forward. Hands down, head up, jump back or step back. Come down. Arch up. And push back, down dog. Raise the left leg up in the air.
Lost my sense of direction.
And swing the foot up into the crescent pose. Then lean out over the front leg. Don't come up. Keep the back foot down. You can groove here. And slowly come on out into the balance. Slowly doesn't work. Fast as possible. As always, the hands can be in front of you or behind you. Generally, it's easier with the hands behind you, but so what? Experiment. And bring the hands down and the leg up, standing splits. Legs are straight as you can get them. And bring the foot down, feet together. Roll all the way up, stretch up, arch back a little bit. Exhale, come all the way forward.
I could be lost inside
there. Stay here for a second, relax. Keep the breath moving. Okay, roll all the way up, stretch up. Arch back a little bit. Exhale, come all the way forward.
A blessing to a curse.
Step the feet apart, about hip distance or so. Interlock the hands behind your back, drop them over your head. Roll the weight toward the balls of the feet if you can. If that's too much, don't do that part. Make sure your neck is relaxed. Bring the hands down to the floor. Just hang there and relax. We'll be right back to do more yoga.
You're watching Oxygen Media.
And we're back. So we're going to do a kind of a semi-radical balance pose. It's called the standing bow. You grab the inside of the left foot or ankle, inside you grab. Right hand comes straight up in the air. Slowly, you lean forward as you kick the back foot back.
Please give a helping hand, oh God.
Extend out with the fingers.
To guide all of us together.
Breathe while you're here occasionally. That's nice. Slowly come down. Let's try the other side. Same thing. Grab the inside of the right foot this time. Left arm straight up in the air. Lean forward as you really kick back with that back leg. If you were to do this in front of the mirror, the back foot would come straight up over your head. Stay with it if you can. And slowly come down. Just hang forward for a moment. In India, they use that posture a lot to show off because it's balance, flexibility, and strength all in one pose. Thank God we're not in India. For a lot of reasons. All right, slowly roll all the way up. Sit down on the floor. Bring the legs wide apart as you can. Kind of extend the heels. Now, if this is enough, you can stay here. Generally, it isn't. So just walk yourself out as far as possible. All the way down if you can. Keep the breath moving here. Thighs to stretch open, your low back to decompress. Just stay here and breathe. What we need is love. There's a lot of different styles of yoga. Some are very intense and gymnastic. Some are very slow and meditative. And they're all good. It just depends on where you are at any given moment. It's nice to switch up and do all kinds of yoga. It's good, all of it. And while we're here, just go out over your left leg. Keep the legs wide apart, though. Straight out over if you can. If that's too much, you can drop the left shoulder down and right shoulder up and do a kind of a twist. But otherwise, try to keep the shoulders level. It makes it more intense on the leg. Keep the breath moving here, even if you don't think you need it. Slowly come up. Do the other side. See if you can push the left leg down at the same time. You should get a nice intoxicated feeling if you breathe deep. And you stay in this pose, especially today. What's Norman doing? This is an interesting variation. Based on the Spanish Inquisition. Okay, come on up. Now keep the left leg where it is. Bend the right leg like so. We'll do a variation of what we just did, but slightly different. And that is, we're going to twist in this one. So bring the left elbow down to the floor or knee. You can just rest your head if you're feeling extremely lazy. On the left hand, right arm comes straight over your head, right over the ear. The more you can kind of roll the right shoulder back and the left shoulder under, the better. As you get very flexible here, you may be able to grab the left foot with both hands rather than resting on the elbow, but that doesn't matter. Either one is fine. Except for this.
Sâu sông mùa lá cỏ thương anh.
come up. Other side is waiting for you. Whenever you do both sides of something, usually one side is tighter than the other. That's normal. They say it's because the doctor picked you up by one leg and shook you when you first popped out, but who can be sure? Most Hatha Yoga is based on two principal texts in India, one called the Hatha Yoga Pradipika and another one called the Yoga Sutras. In those texts, Hatha Yoga, the postures are mentioned very little, very, very little. So that means whenever you go to a yoga class and someone says, do this, do that, do this, do that, and all this very detailed stuff, it's all made up. Which is not bad, it's just in the actual text, it says lie on your stomach, for example, push your upper body up. That's all it says. When you go to a class, they say pull the shoulders back, and it's based on refinements of it, but you don't want to get attached to anybody's particular interpretation unless you like to be attached and limited. Then it's okay. Come on up. Bring both legs out in front of you. Grab the big toes if you can. If you can't, don't worry about it. Inhale, and as you exhale, bring the forehead toward the shins. Relax your neck. Take some deep breaths. Gonna stay here for a little bit. Long, slow, deep breaths, especially the exhalation is very slow, just to calm you down, start to bring you into that space. Whenever you do forward bends like this, it's calming to the nervous system. So it has this kind of sedative effect. So if you can't sleep at night, for example, and you do this for a few minutes, then you'll be relaxed enough to sleep, or even if you're not, you'll still be relaxed and can't sleep. But in any way you look at it, it's fun. So just stay here. We'll be back very soon.
Inhale, we'll be back in a moment.
And we're back in one of the most favorite poses of anyone. Shavasana, dead man's pose. We'll all get there someday, but now we're just posing. So in this moment, just spread out, relax. Sense the body. By that I mean just feel everything, subtle or gross, on the level of feeling. Don't think about it, don't imagine the body, just feel it. Be aware of your breath. You don't have to manipulate it, but just know how it, notice how it just comes in very gently and automatically. The yogis say 21,600 times a day, you breathe. Out of that number, how many of them are you aware of? Probably very few. And why? Because your mind is externalized, which is normal in this culture, but it's useful to be able to turn it off. If you can't find the off switch to the mind, then you get frantic and crazy. So you want to just allow yourself in this moment to just feel. And in that feeling, you forget all the conceptual thinking and you just allow yourself to be. Not being this or that, just being. Even science says what is appearing is not what is really. If you take an electron microscope and you look into the body or any solid, so-called solid object, 99.something% is space, with only a little bit of energy pulsating and vibrating. So in other words, what you think you are, this body, it's just a thought. It's not how it appears. It's just space and energy. For the moment, in a certain form, the form will change and drop, but you who's aware of it remains. That's what the yogis say. So allowing your attention to slowly return, if you were fortunate enough to go out, keeping the eyes closed, just roll gently to one side or the other. And then bring yourself up into a sitting position, facing the front. Keep your eyes closed. Hatha yoga, the yoga done with all the postures like we're doing here, it's beautiful, but if it's not done with love or with some kind of celebration, then it's just gymnastics. Then it's just circus. Insufficient for happiness. It'll keep you in good shape, and that's good. And you want to do it, but you want to do it with the attitude that there's more going on. Much more going on. So just allow yourself to melt into this moment as much as you can. But as you melt, bring the palms together into the namaste position. And we say namaste.